We still are at the Draft Horse Show. This is not a quarter horse back here. This is a Clydesdale, and I am with Steve Gregg, the owner of this horse, correct?
Correct.
And it's a yearling, is that what you call
Actually,
it?
Actually, it's just this year's baby. He's about 9 months old, this guy. He was first prize stallion foal here today. So
you're a proud dad. So behind me is the most beautiful Percheron I've ever seen, and she just won such a prestigious award. I'm with Ryan Berger, her owner, right, and trainer.
Correct.
Okay, Ryan, this is a familiar face to me, Dean Woodbury of Blue Ribbon Farms. We spoke last year, so how has your year gone?
Very good. We've had a tremendous year. We've traveled a lot of miles, and we've done very well showing this year.
So you're a proud dad, right?
Oh, yeah, I guess you could say that.
So you have all Clydesdales?
Yes, we keep all Clydesdales at our farm. Yep. We're from Ontario, Canada, so we show here every year. It's a tremendous draft horse show here, so.
So you're the international of the international draft horse show,
that.
Right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, do you want to talk about the award that she just won?
Yes, Mackenzie, she won the all-breed Supreme Champion here at the Michigan Great Lakes International, and that was the best stallion, mare, and gelding of each breed, and they were competed for the best of their breed, or supreme of all breeds.
We were watching when she got that award, and she just pranced through that ring. Is it, does she know she's doing this, or what do you think it is that made her stand out?
Well, she likes to stand out. That's kind of her personality, and that's a lot of what makes her special is that she likes and shows off to people in the crowd, and she thinks she's special, we'll put it that way.
Certainly.
We've won at the All-Breed Classic Series. We won that over all Belgians, Perches, and Clydes. We won the World Show a week ago out in Springfield, Massachusetts. We won the 8, the 6 all 3 nights, team and the cart. And now we're at Michigan Great Lakes showing.
So what's the secret to all that? They really want to perform for you, right?
Yes, but it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work at home before you get to the shows. That's where everything is done, is at home, and then going out on the road, because we have traveled a lot of miles this summer.
So. And so you have your own horses, but you also train someone else's horses or other people's horses?
To a degree. We show some of our own, and then we're involved with a couple other people that we show for and with, and our part owners with and whatnot, so yeah.
Just walk me through your day. It can't be an easy day.
Well, yeah, it's a lot of work to it, obviously. It's one of those things where, there's work all the time.
It certainly is. So what does it take to end up at the top of that circle? What kind of training? What is it that they're looking for?
Well, first it starts with the breeding, and you have to have the right genetics, and then the training and fitting them so they look the best. And shoeing is very important. It's probably one of the most important things that is done is good shoeing and clean legs and great action. That's going to get you a long ways in the show ring.
Talk about you're not road worthy yet, are you?
Oh no, we're still going, but we probably are one of the most traveled hitches that are here.
Yeah, that's a rumor that I've heard too. Give us a little background of your farms. I know we talked about it last year, but remind our viewers what's the history and how you got involved.
Yes, my name is Dean Woodbury, and I work for Jim and Peg Day out of Iowa and Albert and Karen Cleavy out of Missouri. I keep all the main hitch horses at my place, and Jim and Albert both raise and breed Percherons, and we also have Belgians there at home that we raise and breed, and we have a few Percherons of our own. So there's a lot of history in both of their families and our families with the draft horse breed.
You could work all the time. Like, for example, we started at 5 o'clock this morning. The horses are all hand-walked for exercise in the mornings. And, of course, fed, watered, washed, and cleaned, and then prepared for the show ring. So, from 5 o'clock this morning till about a half an hour ago, we didn't stop, and now we're just starting to prepare another one for the next class. So, and most days are like that. It's a bit busy, and ours, we're fortunate. It's a family operation, but everybody's pretty willing to work, and makes it all work pretty well. So
all hands on deck.
Correct. Correct.
Talk about the shoeing a little bit, because it didn't even occur to me, but it has to do with her gait and everything else, right?
Correct. I mean, it's going to accentuate her action, and especially her hock action and how she stands. So that's very important. It's going to help make the presence of her foot look, you know, large. So very important, the shoeing.
And how long has she been shoeing?
All her life. She's 3 years old, and she's been shoeing since she was a foal.
I've talked to a lot of people that are second, third generations into this. Is that the case for you as well?
Yes, I'm like the fourth generation, and my son will be the fifth generation in the draft horse industry.
Correct.
So tell me the difference between a Percheron or a Clydesdale, the Shires. They're all gorgeous. Is there a temperamental difference or a work ethic difference? What is it?
Well, there are some differences. All right, they're all draft horses, and they're all of that category. The Clydesdales, obviously, their features, the hair on their legs and whatnot, and they're more, they maybe don't tend to be quite as big as some of the other draft breeds, but there are some very big Clydesdales, too. But the Belgians will quite often be the biggest and strongest, possibly. Percherons are extremely good show horses, good moving horses. Temperament-wise, I mean, there's good and bad in every breed, but in general, they're all pretty good. The Clydesdales are probably the most easy-tempered and better-natured of all the breeds. But I mean, there's not a lot of difference. I mean, the Percherons are always gray and black in color. Belgians will be sorrel or blonde or chestnut. And the Clydesdales can be any color, but they will have the white legs. There's blacks to roans to whites to bays and... But the bay color is the more prominent color in the Clydesdale breed. So,
and they're obviously happiest when they're working. So what is a normal day for them when you're not on a circuit, you're not showing them?
Most days, like the horses, for example, that we're driving in the hitch, we try to hook them for exercise and practice. And they don't get it every day, but they get as many days as we can, you know, 3-4 times a week for sure. So they're hooked and driven for half an hour to an hour type of thing, or sometimes more if they need it, but quite often that's what they get. And basically feeding and oiling and cleaning. We oil their legs a lot to keep the hair white and good on their legs and keep it from breaking and stuff. So, and grooming, obviously, like just grooming their coats every day. So it's a big job. It's full time. There's a lot to it. It's one of those things where there's always work. You could keep working at them many hours you're up if you wanted to, you know, so, yeah.
And I have to ask you this. I've been asking everybody else this history. I know that you're a veterinarian, correct?
Yes.
So how did you get into raising horses as well?
I'm a fourth generation myself, Percheron breeder, and and actually, Mackenzie here, her mother was supreme champion here when she was a three-year-old in 2003, so, yeah. So,
well, thank you for taking the time to talk to us, and good luck in the future.
Thank you very much.
Yes, so it's in the blood. What's ahead for this year for you?
After here, we go to the Raw Winter Fair in Toronto, Canada. And we have a few sales in between. Actually, we got Topeka sale in Indiana. Be in a week, I think, after this. And then I think we have another week, and then we leave for Toronto. And then after we get home from Toronto, we'll probably back off for a while. And start getting things ready for next year.
So we'll see you here next year at MSU at the Michigan Great Lakes International, right?
I sure hope so. We've actually been to every Michigan Great Lakes International. We didn't show horses at the first one, but we have ever since then. We were at the first one, but we didn't bring any horses in, but we've showed at every one of them since.
And that's 37 shows, 38 shows that you've been to. That's pretty fantastic. Thank you so much for talking with us today.
Thank you.
Keeping the breed alive, keeping the spirit of the draft horse or the workhorse alive, I really appreciate that you and your peers do that. So what's in the future for this baby?
Well, he will be left as a stallion at this point for at least one or maybe two more years. And if we feel that he's good enough, confirmation-wise and quality-wise, to stay as a stallion, he will. If not, then we'll geld him, and he'll go into the hitches as a gelding. And he'll be big enough and good enough for that. So likely that he'll stay as a stallion, but it's not for sure, you know, but he'll definitely stay as a show horse.
And that determination will be made by you as well as the judges, right? So how he does in the next year or so?
Yep, for sure. Yeah, between us both. And probably more, but it'll be more so our own opinion. The judging in general is very good at most of the shows. Obviously, it's not like a race, but it's good. And they get very good qualified judges on most of the shows. So it's a good thing to go by, for sure.
Stales, one more thing I want to ask you about. There is a world event for Clydesdales next year. Do you want to talk about it a little bit?
Sure would. I'm actually co-chair of this event. Every 4 years, there's a breed that hosts a world championship. And we are doing it as Canadians next year. The last one was in Madison, Wisconsin, hosted by the Clydesdale Breeders of the United States. So it's planned for like the last week of September of next year, just a small year from now. There'll be, you know, 400 to 600 Clydesdale horses. It's strictly a Clydesdale show. Show up for it. So it's a pretty big event. It's internationally attended. There'll be Scottish, Australian people coming. It's quite a big event. So yeah, we're pretty excited about it. So plans are well underway, and it's going to happen. So
where will that happen at?
London, Ontario, Canada. So it's a very new facility that's very up to date. In fact, very similar to this facility we're in here, and it's a town that's, you know, very easy to get to for a lot of people, as well as all the the stuff that's needed to host the show, hotel wise and whatnot. So yeah, it should be good.
So if people are interested in participating, is it too late for them to sign up? Can they get in touch with somebody to do that?
Sure. We have a website, so just World Clydesdale Show. They will give a lot of information of, you know, motels, when it's happening, how to do, whatever. So as far as showing there, I mean, obviously, entry dates will be a couple months ahead of the show. But, that website should give them all the details they need to know. Yeah. So.
Well, good luck next year. Like you said, it's a short year away. Yeah. I know that you're well in preparation, and you're doing shows besides. So thank you for talking with us.
Okay.